first night of snow, right? It's really Merry Christmas now. But it's a thrill for me this particular week because of my friend here. Look who's here. John McLaughlin. Buddy from 1970, whenever it was, through to present, that's the great Lenny White on drums. And my newer buddy, the amazing Victor Wooten on bass. Before we begin, I want to acknowledge two amazing people in my life, because once I get into the music, I may forget to do that. So I'm going to do it now. I want to tell you that tonight in the house is a man who I've known, a great dear friend of mine who I've known since 1970. I don't know when it was. Where's Fred? What? 19 whatever, right? From Oregon. Anyway, Fred and I have been very dear friends. He's my martial arts instructor, although I haven't been doing it for a while. But I learned a lot from him, and I call him Sifu Fred because Sifu is the Chinese word for teacher. And I love him. He's a great champion. He's a black belt of 90 degrees. I don't know what it is, but. And I wrote a song for him called Sifu, and he's here tonight. Sifu Fred. Fred King. Fred King. There he is right there. Thank you, Fred, for coming to my birthday party. I have another amazing event tonight. A man is here tonight who has actually made an amazing difference in the health of my life. For the past, 8, 10 years, myself and my wife. And he's a nutritionist, he's a doctor, and when I began to use his nutritional methods, it really, really put me in the zone that I wanted to be. And he's very well known, I think, amongst people who know about him. He's the author of the famous book, Eat to Live, and he's here tonight, and we've never met, and we're going to meet. Dr. Joel Fuhrman is here. Thank you for coming. Thank you so much. Thank you. John said, how about live to eat? Okay, we got to talk. All right, so John, we're going to begin now. And again, thank you all for coming to my birthday party.
Thank you. Hi, friends. Welcome. Welcome. I got a couple of words to say. Just hello. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here. We're all here for the same reason. In the end, for the music and for the man behind the music. And for me personally, oh yeah, yeah, let's have a round of applause. We go back 47 years. That's a long time. Yeah, I know. Enough to make you feel old. But we're not. We're still 29-year-old, young, old hippies. And nothing wrong with that. We could use more hippie values in this wacky world today. In any event, I'm just thrilled to be here. And when Sheik invited me to play the last week, how am I going to say no? He's my friend, gracious man, wonderful musician, an inspiration throughout my life and beyond. Thank you, Chick, and a happy birthday.
Thank you, John. We're going to play a song that John wrote for me a couple of years ago, and we finally got around to playing it together. This is called Chick's Chums.
And I just wrote it like that. You know, we haven't even chatted or anything.
Yeah. Right.
Chick's Chums. Not one of them.
How do we start? We just start in B.
Thank you.
continue now into back into the... By the way, that opening tune that we played was called Hymn of the Seventh Galaxy. That's from the recording Hymn of the Seventh Galaxy. And after Chicks Chumps, now we're going to go back to the Return to Forever repertoire and play you the title song called Romantic Warrior.
Thank you. Victor Wooten on the bass. John McLaughlin.
Just a couple of words about the next tune, and when Chick and I were talking about me coming here and finishing on this birthday, 2 months, and have a party every day. Every day. Well, we spoke a little bit about what are we gonna play, and we decided to take a little walk down memory lane, as you have already heard. And we've done pieces from Return to Forever, Mahavishnu, and we've got one from that book, and it goes all the way back to 1971.
Ooh.
And it's a ballad, but you know, we've kind of updated it a little bit. But Shakespeare likes it, and I like it. It's called A Lotus.
beautiful song, John McLaughlin.
What a rendition, unique.
Continue on and invite a very, very special friend up to the stage to play with us on my birthday. He came for my birthday, all the way from Nashville. This is now going to be the Flecktones meets Return Forever meets My Vision. Welcome Baylor Fleck to the stage.
Baylor Fleck.
Are you looking expecting that? Where are you, Baylor? Okay, we're going to get hooked up here, and then we're going to play for you. Bill is just going to wing it with us on this piece. This is from this is from the Hymn of the Seventh Galaxy. It's called Señor Más.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Clegg. Danny Clegg. Thank you very much. Beautiful man.
Danny Love.
Victor Wooten. Danny Wright. Cheerio. Thank y'all.
Let's hear it for the maestro, Chick Corea, yes.
Thank you, you've been a great audience. Thank you very, very much. Yes. Okay, we have another thing now for my birthday to play for you. We have a special song. To be sung by my sweetheart of 45 years, Gail Moran Correa. It's dangerous up here. This stage is a postage stamp. Gail Moran Correa. She's she has the distinction. Here you go, sweetie, over here. She has the distinction of being the only singer that both recorded and performed with the Mahavishnu Orchestra and Return to Forever. And we're gonna do a special song by my request. This is again my birthday, another birthday present, but John said this is fine. John wrote this song that we're gonna do. It's called Smile of the Beyond. And it's from the great recording called The Apocalypse, produced by George Martin and with the London Symphony Orchestra. And Gail is the vocalist on this beautiful recording. And we're gonna do our Blue Note 2016 Merry Christmas version of Smile of the Beyond.
Sweetheart, isn't he cute? I know I can't say too much about it in front of me. This was an amazing moment for me back whenever, a while ago. And John brought in this music. His wonderful compositions to just try it. I was just sight reading it. I was literally a run through like that. And I thought it was just a run through rehearsal, you know. And I walked into the control room, the great George Martin, you know, was there, and he had his hands up. And I thought, ooh, was it bad? Was it, you know? And I said, I'll do it better, I'll do it better. He said, no, that was it. That was it. It was magical. And I said, please, you know, I can get it better and more perfect. And so when you hear the album, it's kind of a little bit. Loose. John, did you want to say anything? Well, he's busy. The recording was just, isn't it these two giants? Well, these four giants, excuse me, four giants on stage. Two forever young. Okay, welcome to our living room. We're working things out. John, did you want to say anything about this recording? Did you want to say anything about the recording while he's busy with the monitor?
There's nothing coming out of here.
I mean, the whole album was just London Symphony Orchestra. My sweetheart here had to reduce the orchestra, London Symphony Orchestra part, all for him, keyboard. But these are John's voicings, his writings. So, you know, they're known, these two guys, for wild and wonderful chords, you know that. And it's a gorgeous, gorgeous piece of music. It's dedicated to the good in all of us and to the dreamer in all of us. and that's what we need to keep remembering in this whole world of ours, is keep the good going, right? Once I thought my goal was so far away, my life an endless search. Now I see within your very smile. Thank you.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Thank you.
Now, when it comes, when you turn up.